Hi guys, I'm just going to do an introduction to a meter kit that you can buy. You can buy these through Lawrence and Hanson or MIDI's or anything. They're a kit you can buy for about $500. I'm going to go through the kit and explain the different aspects of things in it. One of the good reasons about this kit I've got here is 10 year old. The newer one now has steel clips on here, but they haven't changed in the design of the carry case. Now the good thing about the carry case, you put it in your truck, you've got it, and the thing is you've got the three basic meters. So I'll get the guy to come over and we'll take a little bit of a look. So let's have a look at the first meter here. All right, we'll pull this out. This is a multimeter. And what I want you to have a look at is good about this is you've got volts AC, volts DC, you've got ohms, right? So if you push the yellow button in, you get the audio signal or you get ohms. So that's what the yellow button's relating to. All right, then we have amps down here, AC, DC. So you've just got to be a little bit careful on what you're looking at. So you've got your current here for direct or alternating, and the voltages are on the same two different readings. The meters that you don't want to get is when you've got voltage on the same meter and you've got to change the button to change it from AC to DC. The problem is if you're measuring AC and it's on the DC reading, it'll actually show it's dead. So this is where you physically have to join and move these apart. Down here we have the 10 amp range, so we have to plug it in. So normally the two common ones we change are common, voltage, ohms and hertz, and most of the time the meter's stuck in these two here when we do put the leads in. And we have these ones here if we're going to connect it in series for a amp meter. Now what we'll do is we'll hook into this one. Be careful, this one here for the 10 amp is unfused, which means there's no fuse for it. The bottom one down here is fused for 500 milliamps. So between here to here, we put it in series, it gives us a current reading. If we do the 10 amp one, then you've got to remember that's unfused, all right? So that can chop out if you don't have the fuse for it. And then we pick up the amp meter. So very good, robust meter. It also has a drop case on it, so you can take the drop case off. So we have this. This is like a foam rubber, so if I put it in there, right, and I drop it like that or bounce it, it's going to be protected, okay? All right, so we've got the multimeter. The next thing I'm going to move on to is a clamp tester. Now a clamp tester is designed to clamp around a conductor and it measures the magnetic field around it. So what we do with the clamp tester when we've got the wire in there, we measure the magnetic field. So instead of us making an amp meter sit in series, we actually measure the magnetic field that runs around the cable. The more current I got through there, the stronger the magnetic field, and then this is what gives us our current. This excellent meter does both. It measures voltage and it also measures current. The current part, so when we want to use it for voltage, we have voltage and ohms down the bottom here, and we have the common. So we have a set of leads we plug into here. Now, if you have a look on the range up here, we have off, all right, we have 400 volts AC, we have 40 volts AC, all right, then we have AC volts, DC volts is a big difference. We've got to make sure you're measuring AC to DC, there is a big difference. Then we have ohms for ohms and ohm meter, which is a buzzer. We hold here, all right, we can hold that for the buzzing sound with the button here, all right, and then the rest we have for current. So down the bottom here we had volts, 400 amps, 40 amps, and then voltage AC and DC, and back to ohms, all right. So that can be used as a universal tool. That's used for measuring your current. The next one we get down to, notice they all fit really neat. This is what's good about it. We have this foam cutout base that means nothing can physically move. It's a very, very hard foam. It's not like your soft stuff you get. And it's molded into the case. We have a carry case. Now this meter is called a insulation resistance tester. Okay. A lot of you, or insulation resistance tester, it says here, not a mega. All right. Mega is a brand name that we use in the industry. We don't, how can I explain? Mega is a brand name, does the same thing, but yeah, it's not there. It's called an insulation continuity tester. All right, and it's a model. Now this Keritsu one's probably one of the easiest ones to use, because what I like about it is everything on the top scale, which is in pink or red, is measured in these three scales here, which is basically for 1000 volts, 500 volts and 250 volts, and gives you the mega ohm range. Then we have the two blue ones on the bottom, which is 3 ohms and 500 ohms, which are the two different scales we have on the bottom here. Now you've got to remember that this meter reads the opposite way. So zero down here reads here for the mega ohms, for the voltage, when we apply voltage through a circuit. When we do ohms, the zero starts from the opposite side. So they don't all start from the same side as what you think. So zero starts on this side for when we do ohms and goes this way. When we get to the pink range, the zero starts this side and goes this way. The biggest thing you've got to do is when you use it from two different scales is you have this zero adjusting button here. That zero adjusting button is when you have to zero from this side to zero the button. You should be do that. So when you actually switch from here into that range, you need to zero it in to make sure that it's sitting on zero. Okay? So we have the blue scale here for ohms. We would use that to say measure the resistance of a winding of a new motor, all right, or a secondhand motor. We would use the 300 to 500 ohm scale. So if you have a look here, the bottom scale, have a look up the top here, that is from 0 to 500 for the bottom scale. And then the next scale on the top, which is 0 to 3, is for 3 ohms. So once it goes above 3 ohms, we have to go to the bottom scale. You also notice there's a little bit of mirror sitting behind the back here, just up below the red. So where the red is, that's actually a mirror, all right? So you can actually use that to show exactly where the indicator is, all right, and reflect it back on. Now, another thing down here, right down the very end here, we have 0.1 of an ohm and zero. Now, when a lot of people do a heating element, they look at 0.1 and they think, oh, it's this one here. Well, it's not. It's actually the 0.1 is just off the zero. You can just see it there. And the problem is that's one we use for a heating element or whatever, right? So you have a heating element there, which would be 0.1. So it's nearly zero. It's very, very deceiving sometimes. And then we have for a main earth, we come all the way up here to half an ohm. All right, so on that. But this is for power, all right? So what are we measuring on this scale here? Down the bottom here, like I said, we have ohms, all right? So 0.10,000 ohms would be above this 500 scale, all right? Infinity, so when we measure insulation resistance and all that stuff, like I said, 0.1 is right down the very end here, all right? The higher the scale, the more the better the resistance is, okay? And that's what we need to take in. We also have a little light down the bottom corner here, so where it says live circuit, do not operate if lit. So in other words, if we have a 240-volt supply or something in there, it shouldn't be, that little light will light up. Now, another big mistake with these is when people put them on and put the cover on, the button pushes down. That's why I haven't got the cover for this, because when I close a case, the cover gets pushed down, it pushes a button down, and it actually runs the battery flat. All right? We also have another one here called battery test. So what I'm going to do in a minute is I'm going to go through and show you how to use the Mega and what it's used for, and we're going to demonstrate it on a motor, okay? We're going to do a test on a motor, do a test on a toaster, steel frame toaster, just to show what we're talking about with the earth. And we're also going to do one on a plastic appliance just to show you where we don't have an earth that's double insulated, all right? But we'll do the ohms check on it and that stuff like that. All right, so just a quick rundown. You can pick these up for $500, best value for you can buy, and there might be a bit more. Look, I've had this 10 years and it's not damaged, all right? So just one more thing before we go, just the lead. So I always carry a screwdriver so that if I need to take, because a lot of these, like here to change the battery, for example, you need a screwdriver to undo it. So, you know, what I do is I have the screwdriver, I can undo it, take the batteries out and change them, all right? So the screwdriver is a little piece of handy tool. Now when you get down into your meters as well, we have two leads. We have this one here, and we have a black one the same. These are used for the tong tester and the ohm meter. All right, they have their plugs sitting in the end here so they don't get damaged and pins. Then we have another set of leads. Okay, we have the red one with the probe on it. Most of the proper leads, this one's not, this one I lost on the other one, but most of them have, the probe actually pushes in and out. So when you push down, the probe actually pushes back on a spring, all right? And the idea of that is when you make contact with something steel, you're actually putting pressure on to the point on the end here, all right? The other lead we have is a clamp so that you can clamp onto your earth, and it holds it on there for you so you can hold that on, all right? It looks like it's got a funny strap, but actually when you look at it, the strap is made to the design so that it holds the meter like that. So when you're doing the test, you can do your test and you can work hands-free. All right, looks like I've got a handbagger in my head, but yeah, the idea of the strap is to hold it around there. You put it on, you got it on there, and you can take your readings and see what you need to do, okay? All right, well, we'll be back in a minute. We'll do the test on the motor and we'll go through on how to do the insulation resistance test of how you should be on the appliances. All right, any other questions, let me know. I do have another meter over here. It's a bigger tong tester, a bigger clamp meter. Probably a big overkill. This is designed to use on big heavy cables, like something like big mains and all that stuff. Bit of an overkill, but the same thing. Fluke brand, okay? You never have too many meters, okay? So I'll leave you to it, and we'll get back to you later.